final week of April, and we've got a great matchup. We'll see the Oakland Athletics and the Los Angeles Angels. It's the MLB on 2K Sports right now.
Not often do you see a long ball that is that long, but occasionally that fountain does get visited by the Cowhide here in Anaheim. From the American League West, it's the Angels. From the West, it's Oakland. They meet up here in this one. 2K Sports presents our MLB broadcast. So great to have you with us. First month of the season coming to a close. Let's take a look at Anaheim's starter. Steve, what's he got in his mind now as he takes a look at Oakland today?
Well, a little mismatch in this one right here. One of the best lefties in the game against the lineup that does struggle at times to score runs. So it could be a lopsided ballgame.
Here's the lineup for the A's.
That's a prodigious lineup right here. Names that everybody recognizes. A lot of threats in this lineup and no breaks for the opposing pitcher.
Henderson tries to do some damage now. The A's losing yesterday. Well, they ended up splitting the four-game series 2-2 against the Mariners in Seattle.
Well, anytime you're struggling, you could still play 500 ball. That's a good thing.
Swung on, grounded towards the hole. And that's out number one as he takes it to the bag. Now we'll take a quick look at the Angels, how they'll be taking the field defensively. Collins now will come to the plate.
Tell you what, Angels and A's, always a great battle. Two teams that typically have very good pitchers.
One out, base is empty. Takes that first pitch low in the strike zone, strike one. Well, 11-8, we were talking about the Angels against the A's last year. They had the advantage.
Well, they certainly did, but here's the thing. The A's had very good pitching in 2010, but not quite as good as the Angels had, and the Angels' offense just that little bit better than the Athletics.
Here's the pitch. Good pitch on the outside corner, 1-2.
Well, they set up down and away, they throw it down and away. That's how you can be effective as a major league pitcher.
The 1-2 on its way. Fastball just about had him, and it's a 2-2 count. And he changed up for the strikeout, two away.
Well, this thing just about stops as it gets to home plate. The hitter could have reloaded a couple times if he decided to swing. Instead, he just wanted to watch it go by. Let's take a look at last year's rankings and see how the Oakland Athletics fared. Third in stolen bases, ninth in batting average, and they were in the top 10 in hits, a lineup that was able to make a lot of contact and put the ball in play.
Two outs, bases empty. Called strike on the outside corner, 0-1.
Well, a changeup right there hit a good spot. You want to keep that down in the zone, so even if they swing at it, it stays in the ballpark.
Swung on, lined over the first baseman's head. And Oakland, their first hit. Can't cut it off. It's going to roll to the wall. He'll hold there at second base, credit him with a double.
Hey, look, you'd love to see him hit a double earlier in the inning when there's no outs or even one out, but you're going to take anything you can get with two outs. Let's see if they can get another two-out hit to drive him in.
McGuire is batting. Two outs and a runner on second. It's now 0-1. Watch that fastball go by.
Hitters have to have great balance and be prepared for the pitch away. If you open up even a little bit, you can't catch up to that four-seam fastball on the outside corner.
Here's the delivery. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
They went with the big curveball off the plate, trying to get him to reach for it, but he lays off.
Here's the pitch. And he looks at a fastball in there, and it's 1-2 now.
Good pitchers change the hitter eye level. You go down low, then you run the fastball up high. A lot of times they just look at it go by.
One-two pitch coming. And he looks at a fastball that's in there, side retired. They pick up no runs on one hit and leave a man at second. And the Angels, their first chance coming right up. Oakland starter for our ballgame. Steve, as he faces these Angel hitters, what's a primary emphasis?
Well, we got a lefty on the mound in this one. Some of the best stuff in the league among the elite left-handers in the game. Against a lineup, they can certainly put runs up on the board, but you have to believe if the lefty can get the job done, he should put some zeros up.
Here's the pitch. Hit in the air to center field. And the leadoff man of this ballgame's on board. See if they get it started early. Now let's take a look at the lineup for the Angels.
Okay, this is what I call a circular lineup. Stars really throughout the lineup, they're all the same. They hit for average, hit for power, drive-in runs, really star-studded throughout.
Now's a good time to take a quick look at how the Athletics shape up on the field with defense. Runner on first base, nobody out. On the way. Can't get him to chase it. That's low, ball one. Lost in their last contest for the Angels. In a tough four-game series, they lost three, just picking up the one win against the Red Sox. And the pitch out, nothing doing that time. Hit hard on the ground to short. Over to second for one. And Tejada will finish off the double play. And that one's got to be a candidate for play of the week, Steve.
Well, you talk about shifting momentum. You get the ground ball double play, and all of a sudden, you're back in the dugout ready to hit.
Here's a look at what's coming up for the A's. Wednesday, they finish up this Los Angeles series. After that, it's about defending home field. They go against the Rangers and their hitting star, Michael Young. That series bound to be competitive. That's at the end of the week. Then they stay home for the next series, the Cleveland Indians. So a lot of home games on the way. The fans will have a chance to see their guys many times over the next couple of weeks. Two outs and nobody on. Here's the pitch. And he holds off with the pitch low, 1-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
He watches that fastball. It'll even up the count at 1-1.
Well, it's a quality fastball right there. Just pounding the strike zone down and away. He had no chance to put that one in play.
Here's the 1-1. Line drive fouled off towards first. The 1-2 pitch. Swung on, hit in the air to right center. And that gets down for a base hit.
Well, still in the early part of the season. Let's take a look at where the Angels sit right now in the American League. Second in triples, seventh in batting average with runners in scoring position. And they're in the top 10 in team batting average. That depth and length of the lineup paying big dividends for this team as they seem to find ways to get base hits.
Vaughn into the batter's box. Runner on first, two away. Fastball just misses, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. 1-0 delivery is a fastball in there, 1-1.
Well, the hitter lays off this pitch, realizing you can't do much. When you get that kind of four-seam fastball down and away, it's tough to hit.
Good downward action there, and it's 1-2. Pitch on the way. Foul ball behind home plate.
Foul ball!
The 1-2 on its way.
Two and two.
Pitch out. Nothing doing, though. Two-two pitch. Tough pitch to lay off that time. Full count, 3-2.
Flat fastball right there. Just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
And on a full count, smashes that one towards the shortstop. And that's the third out. Tejada grabs it. They pick up no runs on two hits and strand one. We're scoreless in L.A. Going to be Jackson now. That's off the plate away, 1-0.
Well, the hitter didn't take the bait. That's a great pitch. That breaking ball down and away, trying to get the hitter to chase. You have to give him credit. He didn't go out of the zone for it.
Here's the 1-0. And he takes a strike on that fastball, 1-1.
Tough pitch to hit right here. When you run this fastball up and away, you have to elevate your swing to get on top of it. He ends up taking the pitch.
He delivers. Good downward movement on that pitch. It's 1-2.
Boy, that's some kind of fastball down in the zone right there. The hitter has to be ready for it, or he's got no chance to hit it.
Liner between first and second. Vaughn. And he'll step on the bag. That'll be the first out. Now a look at the standings in the Western Division as we get through the first month of the season. It's brought to you by State Farm. Mariners in first place. The A's second place. Rangers in the third spot. And it's the Angels in fourth. Base is empty with one away. Hard grounded to short, number 11. On to first, two away. Cochran is the batter. Base is empty and two down. Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. That looks like a single.
Well, you're going to have to keep a close eye on this guy at first base. Pay a lot of attention to him because you know he more than likely has the green light. He can go at any time.
Let's take a chance here right now to see where the Athletics sit in the American League. Second in home runs, fourth in slugging percentage, and they're in the top 10 in runs scored. That offense relentless, putting up runs and giving themselves a chance to win.
Two outs and a man on first. The 0-0 delivery, a fastball taken for a strike.
Well, they set up down and away, they throw it down and away. That's how you can be effective as a major league pitcher.
The pitch on the ground to first. And he'll step on first to retire the side. Save your arm. Do it by pitching only 8 times in one inning, 3 outs. Still here at Angel Stadium in Anaheim, no score. And if you're just joining in, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Kruk bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. And it's Garrett Anderson in the box now. Career numbers, .318 batting average against the A's. Here's the pitch. There's a swing and a drive, deep right field. As he retreats back for it and gets the out.
Well, let's take a look at the Angels and where they ended up last year rank-wise in the American League. Seventh in home runs, seventh in stolen bases, and they were in the top 10 in doubles, driving the ball out to the wall, playing a lot of wall ball last year, showing that speed coming out of the batter's box and taking the extra bases.
Salmon up now. One out, nobody on. And that's too low, 1-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone, around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Fastball just misses and he falls behind, 2-0. Fastball misses badly. He's in danger of losing him.
The pitcher can't find the zone right here, but I'm still giving my hitter the green light. I think he has enough discipline to get a good pitch and try to drive it.
Lays off that one. Misses ball four.
Off the plate outside. He's missed on four straight. He's got to bring it back in the zone.
And Edmonds settles in. He's hit 283 lifetime off Oakland. One down, runner at first. He delivers. Hit up the middle. And he's up with it. Out. Tejada for one. And two. Double play. Seven pitches and it's done. That's how you save your arm and go deep into a game. We're scoreless in L.A. Bottom of the order to get things started. Miguel Tejada leading it off. He deals. Strikes him out with a fastball for a strike.
Well, the hitter's got to regret that one. He missed his pitch right down the heart of the plate. Four-seam fastball. That hurts.
The pitch, and Miguel Tejada takes a look at that one. A ball evens the count.
Boy, it's a great fastball right there down in the strike zone. Now there's so many ways to go. Let's see how he comes back to attack this hitter.
He swings, hits a ball to right field. It's caught. More MLB coming your way this Wednesday. The New York Mets hit the road. They make the trip to Washington to face the Nationals. Going to be starting at 7 o'clock Eastern.
Well, I guess, look, if you and John are going to be at that one, I want to go do that game, too, because that looks like it's going to be a good one.
Henderson tries to do some damage now. Ground out victim last time through. One out, bases empty. And the first pitch. Watches that fastball. That goes by him for a strike. Ball. That misses downstairs for a ball. 1-1. Here's the pitch. Slider just off the black that time, 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. 2-1 pitch, a fastball. Swung on and missed, 2-2. Oh! 2-2 is a changeup that misses. 3-2.
Well, that's where you look for a changeup from the pitcher away in the strike zone. If they look for it and get it, they can really shoot that thing the other way and do some damage.
The 3-2 pitch.
You're out.
Swing and a miss. Slider, two down.
Oh, Gary, that's an outstanding slider. That great late action. With two strikes, not much you can do with that one. Tough one to hit.
On tap for the Angels. Final game with Oakland is Wednesday. And they'll have to deal with Carl Crawford. The travel schedule will take them to Tampa Bay. That's a team they handled all right the last time up. They'll try for a repeat performance. That'll be a three-game series. Then they'll continue on with another road series. The Red Sox hosting that one. So they'll be out and about over a good bit of that upcoming schedule. Two outs, bases empty. The first pitch. Takes that high one for a strike, 0-1.
Well, climbing the ladder with that four-seam fastball, trying to get the hitter to elevate his eyes. He gets the strike on it, and the hitter doesn't pull the trigger.
Here's the pitch. Swings on the 0-1 pitch, can't hit it. Strike two. Fouled off. Oh, and he saws him off as this one's hit on the ground. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. Three up, three down this half inning. The Athletics can't get the offense going. Leadoff batter will get a shot at it later on in this inning. And their number six hitter. He'll get us going here in the home half of the third.
Ball!
And he lays off one low, 1-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Ball! Fastball misses badly. He's behind 2-0. Fastball just misses. He runs it to 3-0.
Well, that fastball right there just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
Here's the 3-0 pitch. Fastball is taking all the way, 3-1.
But clearly the hitter had the take sign on right there. He was taking all the way.
Here it comes. And that's ball four, and that's going to put a runner on to maybe start an offensive inning.
That's a bad omen for a pitcher. Lead off, base on ball, sure indication of where his control is.
And that'll bring up Benji Molina.
You don't want to do this in this kind of a situation. Put a walk on base with a guy who's the go-ahead run in the game. That's a mistake.
Runner on first, no outs. On the way. Watches a fastball that's in there. 0-1. And what he's done here in this situation with the walk coming where it did, Steve, is really give the offense a lot of options.
As a pitcher, you can't try to miss bats. Go at them, throw strikes, make them put it in play, let the defense work.
Here's the delivery. Swung on, a fly ball down the left field line. And it drops in for a base hit. Boy, they've opened the door. Can Anaheim go through it?
They tried to go down with that 0-1 pitch, but it gets blasted right back for the base hit.
And by the way he went after that in the box, Steve, it looked like he might have been guessing down there.
Well, I'll tell you what, you have to make contact behind in the count. He got a pitch over the heart of the plate and took advantage of it.
Runners at first and second. Nobody out. Now the first pitch.
Ball.
Fastball, too low, 1-0. Now one ball, one strike. He watched that fastball that was in there.
Unless you stay back and really think about going the other way, you've got no chance of hitting that four-seamer down and away.
Ball. Hit that one right back up the middle. And there's one. And Tejada will finish off the double play. Cleanup man in the box again. We'll get another shot after hitting into that double play last time up. Man on third, two down. And the first pitch. Fastball in there, 0-1.
Now that he's established the bottom of the strike zone, it gives him so many options. He can go to the breaking ball or climb the ladder with another fastball.
Called strike outside corner. Quickly in the hole now, 0-2. Tries to ring him up with a fastball away, but it's 1-2. One-two pitch coming. And he watches that one travel down. 2-2. Fastball is low that time. The count runs full.
Boy, it's a great fastball right there down in the strike zone. Now there's so many ways to go. Let's see how he comes back to attack this hitter.
The 3-2 pitch.
Ball four.
And that one is going to be outside. And that is ball four. And now you've got a base stealer on.
Well, you just saw a great deal of plate discipline right there on the hitter. Maybe a little fatigue on the pitcher's part. They're not used to throwing that many pitches in one at bat, but the hitter wins it and gets that base on balls.
Baylor in the box now.
Now, Gary, we just saw the second walk in this inning, and you really have to start to question, is he nibbling, trying to avoid contact, or is he losing control?
Here's the pitch. It's strike one. Can't make contact on the fastball. And Steve, absolutely right about those walks here. He's got himself in a jam. He doesn't get out of it. His part of the game may be over.
Well, he's finding himself in hitters' counts. And when hitters can look for a certain pitch, they can drive it. So he's in trouble.
And they pitch out. Nobody's moving. He's running towards second.
Ball two.
He throws. Throw offline. He is in there third. Fastball on the black. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, this is your dream when you're in the on-deck circle before you go into the batter's box. If you can get the count to 3-1 and in your favor, you know you have the upper hand.
That misses ball four. So that's going to set up a force at any base now with two outs.
It goes with the fastball in the three-ball count, which is what he should do here. Be aggressive, but he throws it out of the zone, and now base is loaded.
Vaughn into the batter's box. Steve, we talk about game-turning situations. This is one of them.
No question about that. Things can change completely right here.
Two outs. Bases loaded. Here's the first pitch. Oh, what a drive. He smashed it. And that's going to do it in this half inning. So they pick up no runs, one hit, and strand a couple. We're scoreless in L.A. Fox is the batter now. He doubled his last time. And here's the first one. Here's a swing and a line drive. And it's caught by Ekstein.
Well, that's an atom ball right there. That ball was smoked. He stung it, but right at the second baseman.
McGuire settles in, took a called third strike in his last time up. One out, nobody on. First pitch to him. Hit in the air to left center. That one gets through for a base hit.
Well, he did his job right there, getting on base. Now with one out, let's see if they can move him around and get him in scoring position.
It's going to be Jackson now. 0 for 1 thus far. One out, runner on at first. First pitch. Slider just misses, 1-0.
Look, Gary, the way this is going so far here in the fourth, I mean, they do have three hits. So they've had a couple of base runners, but I think that because they're not mounting hit after hit, they may have to put some plays on to get the runners moving.
1-0 is a fastball that runs away, 2-0. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. And that's a base hit. Gets down in front of him. Boy, what a time now to capitalize if they can.
He goes right with the pitch and slaps the ball into left field.
And if you try and pull that pitch, you're probably not even going to get the bat on it.
That's a ground ball to second base if he pulls that one.
One out with runners at first and second. Here's the pitch. And that's on the outside corner for a strike.
This is the go-to pitch for many pitchers in the major league. The fastball down and away. When in doubt, that's where you go.
That swung on and a liner here. That's one. Whoa, they just bungled that one. That throws to the wrong base.
Well, he keeps the runners right where they are, so now he's just an out away from working his way out of danger and keeping this game tied.
Two men on and two men out. Here's the first pitch. Watches that fastball. That goes by him for a strike.
He's just popping that glove with that four-seam fastball, pounding the strike zone.
Good hard slider that time. He's in control in the count now, 0-2. Slider swung on and missed. Struck him out. That's going to retire the side. So, no runs, two hits, and they strand two. The shutout continues in L.A. Garrett Anderson to lead off. Here's Anderson's first look. Starts him out with a fastball for a strike.
Oh, good life on this fastball as he just buries it down and away.
There's a swing and a ball lifted high, deep, down the line and right. Tell it goodbye. And they get the first run of the ball game. That solo shot, that is a big fly ball, 1-0.
But Gary, looked like he was setting on that pitch. He got it and drove it out of the park.
What they're going to want to do in this ballgame now is take advantage of that and build that momentum up.
Well, they need to still be aggressive out there and go right after. Angels get themselves a lead right here, Gary. Good approach at the plate. by this Anaheim team.
No outs and the base is empty. And that's too low, 1-0. This is a really momentum feel home run. You get it at this point of the ball game, you add some juice to the whole offense.
Well, this could be a decisive moment in the game. I mean, these hits early on could ultimately impact the result at the end of the game.
And that's off the plate, away, ball two. And the 2-0 pitch is a fastball low, 3-0.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone, around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Ball four, he walked him.
Well, it looked like he was taken all the way right there, Gary. He walked him on four straight pitches.
And Edmund settles in.
Well, listen, he's had a real difficult time throwing strikes in this one, Gary. Now the runs coming at him a little bit here. He's got to find a way to make his pitch when he needs to.
Runner on first. First pitch on the way. Fastball is downstairs. One ball, no strikes. Well, maybe, Steve, you got one of those ball games where he just feels better, works harder when he's having to focus more.
Well, you know, from the manager's perspective, he's in there watching it saying, I know he's bending a little bit, putting guys on base, but he's so far found a way to make the pitches he needs to, but sooner or later, you're playing with fire with that many guys on.
And it's starting to head out towards the wall. He's thinking extra bases. He's on his way to the plate, and he crosses the plate all the way from first base.
Now the pitcher left this one over the middle part of the plate, right where the hitter can make contact. Good piece of hitting.
Boy, with a run scoring there, that's a pretty fat pitch in an RBI situation.
Keep the rally going.
And the cleanup man stands in. Just one player picking up after another, Steve. This is a good offensive show going on, and they're climbing the ladder with it.
Well, you have to credit this lineup, Gary. Some quality at bats right now and taking advantage of the opportunities, and now they have a lead.
The pitch. Fastball, too low, 1-0. And it may be early going. They've got a chance, though, to maybe put this ball game away and put a little defeatism on the other side.
Well, what I really like is their approach at the plate. They're waiting for their pitch, and when they get it, they're driving it, taking advantage of every mistake the pitcher's making.
Inside with the fastball, 3-0.
Well, anytime you're throwing a fastball down in the zone, especially down and in, the only thing a hitter can do is hit that ball into the ground. Good job of laying off.
Look out, that one ran in and got him.
Well, if this is on purpose, there's absolutely no place for this in the game. I hate to see this.
RBI opportunity right here for Benji Molina.
I don't know if you got a chance to see his last ball game, but he picked up two hits in that one, swung the bat well.
No one out yet, runners at first and second. First delivery to Molina. Line towards second. There's one. Not going to get two, though, trying to get it to Tejada, but not in time.
This ball scorched right at the second baseman, but he showed quick reflexes to be able to make the play.
And we've got Eckstein batting.
Well, no one's going to mistake David Eckstein for a guy that has unbelievable talent, and that's why he's in the major leagues. But what he is a winning ball player, do anything he can to help his team. And when you're putting a team together, you need guys like this.
Fastball is downstairs. One ball, no strike.
No, guys, I just love watching David Eckstein play. I mean, you talk about effort, look the word up, there's his picture.
I agree. I think you look in the dictionary and you look at the word pest, you're going to see his picture there as well. He fights off so many great pitches from the pitcher, keeps at bats alive, and lets the guys behind him in the lineup see the entire repertoire pitcher has.
Here's the delivery. And that's down and in around the shoe tops. 3-0 now. A lifetime 290 hitter against the A's. Can make contact on that bunt attempt. That's a strike. He's ready. The 3-1.
Ball four.
And he missed ball four. That's going to load the bases.
It goes with the fastball in the three ball count, which is what he should do here. Be aggressive. But he throws it out of the zone, and now base is loaded. Well, big-time pressure, Monty, for the man they call Huddy out there, Gary, Tim Hudson.
And he's getting his thoughts together out there, and he needs to. Already down by two, and maybe more to come.
Gary, the best pitchers are the guys who can flush out the bad thoughts and focus on the task at hand. He can't worry about what got him in this situation.
The rookie shortstop in. And he's getting his thoughts together out there, and he needs to. Already down by two, and maybe more to come.
Gary, the best pitchers are the guys who can flush out the bad thoughts and focus on the task at hand. He can't worry about what got him in this situation.
Now Hudson with the 0-1 pitch. Looks at that curveball. It's a strike. He's behind 0-2.
Now you go with the big breaking ball away. It's exactly where you want to go. Set up hard in and go soft away. Nice pitch.
Ball!
Blowing away with that one. It's 1-2. The 1-2 on its way. Hard slider misses 2-2. He's ready. The 2-2 pitch. Brings that curveball just about at him, but it's full.
Wow, he had some good bite on that one right there, but the hitter wouldn't chase it.
The 3-2 pitch. Fouled away.
Foul.
The 3-2 pitch. Sinker swung on, miss. That's out number two.
Let's see what the K-Cam looks like on a sinker ball.
Fantastic piece of pitching to get that out, John.
Well, that's the part of pitching you love. He's looking for a fastball. He's expecting a fastball. And then just drop one right off the table. What a pitch.
Bases are loaded with two down. The first pitch. And that's in there at the letters for a strike.
Now, Gary, I think he decided that was a pitch he needed to take. As soon as it came out of his hand, just can't handle that fastball up and away.
Pitch on the way. Good hard sinker. Swung on and missed. 0-2. Hit hard on the ground towards third. Throws to first, side is retired. Three innings of nothing, and now here in the fourth, the runs. Anaheim leads it 2-0. Bando batting now. Here's the first pitch. First pitch, and he misses the fastball. Strike one.
Well, outstanding pitching effort so far here. I mean, he's left three runners on base in this game. I mean, but he's just shutting down this lineup, and when he needs to make a pitch, he seems to always find a way to do it.
Plays off the changeup. Good pitch, but it's 1-1.
Well, that pitch right there, that changeup away, if a guy's looking for it, that's a great pitch to be able to hit the other way with some power.
Lined right at the second baseman. And Eckstein on the pickup. Over to first for out number one. And it's Miguel Tejada at the plate. Talk about a career. How about a long one? 15 years. Base is empty with one away. First pitch to Tejada. Line towards first. That gets down. That'll put him on. The tying run up.
Well, a little action going right now for this team. A single here with one out. Little bit of momentum. Let's see if they can bring him across.
Henderson tries to do some damage now. Struck out swinging last time. One out, man on first. Here's the pitch. First pitch, a fastball. That's in there for a strike.
A good four-seam fastball right there. You have to know yourself. He didn't think he could catch up to it. Better off to take it.
Missed badly with the fastball there. 1-1. One pitch, slider, taken for a strike, 1-2.
When in doubt, go down and away. He throws the slider exactly where he wants to. Tough pitch to hit.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, second out in the inning.
Good velocity on that. You can get away with making some mistakes at that kind of number.
And I think last couple of pitches he faced, it didn't seem like he was ready for that fastball.
Yeah, he got some off-speed pitch the previous pitch, but you should be able to expect to get the bat on that heater, especially with two strikes.
Runner on first, two away. Here's the first pitch. Fastball is in there. It's 0-1. Missed with the fastball outside, and it's even at one. He lays off that one, but it's a called strike, 1-2.
Well, he has great rotation on his breaking ball right here, and he hits the perfect spot. The hitter just gave up on it.
The 1-2 pitch. Change up, got him, and the side is retired. No runs on a base hit. They leave one man on at first. The Angels still enjoying this lead. Out of the order, due to bat next. Vaughn into the batter's box. He'll lead off for the home team here in the home half of the fifth. First pitch to him.
Ball!
And he watches the low pitch from Hudson.
Well, that's the pitch you want for the ground ball out, that two-seam fastball at the bottom of the strike zone. Just couldn't quite catch the plate. Good eye by the hitter.
Sinker just off the black, falls behind 2-0. The 2-0. Fastball can't catch the corner. He's behind 3-0.
A good action on that pitch running away, but it's a ball you have to get down to the zone. Don't throw it up.
Here's the delivery. Caught looking at a fastball, 3-1 now.
Well, he missed his spot with that one and got away with it. You want to go to the corners with that four-seam fastball. He found the heart of the plate, but didn't cost him anything.
He swings and nails a liner. That's one down. And Garrett Anderson up. He's the leader in home runs and RBIs in the ball club. Base is empty, one out. Here's Anderson's first look.
Ball.
And he watches the low pitch from Hudson.
He's getting it done all season long, Gary, and a guy they're really looking to count on.
On the way. A shot up the middle, and it gets down. That's hit number two, making good contact.
Well, with one out here and a guy on first base, the last thing you want to do is hit into a double play. Let's see if he can stay away from that.
Salmon gets a turn here. He walked and later scored his last time through. Runner at first with one down. Got him to chase that one away. Strike one.
You know, movement, deception, velocity. He has all of those with his sinker ball, and boy, it is an effective pitch.
Here's the pitch.
Ball.
Nice reflexes there to keep that one under control. That one was in the dirt. And with that great sinker ball, what you're looking for is a good defensive team behind him because they're going to be working.
Well, he's pitching to contact. He's not looking for swings and misses. He knows that if they hit it, they're going to hit it in the ground.
Trying to hit that one to the parking lot, but missed. 1-2. And that one gets popped way up behind the plate. That's the second out. And Edmonds settles in. He's 10 for 25 over his career off Hudson. A runner on first with two outs. Here's Edmonds' first look. Swung on and fouled away. He watches the low pitch from Hudson.
Good spot there, just down a little bit out of the zone. Tried to get him to chase. He wouldn't go for it.
The pitch. That's taken outside for a ball two. One strike count. The 2-1. Lined hard down the left field line. And that's a base hit. Edmonds on board. Boy, they've opened the door. Can Anaheim go through it?
You want your hitters to go with the pitch. Don't try to force things. The ball's away. He drives it away.
Use the whole part of that plate and the whole part of that bat. He did.
Kids, you want to learn how to hit? That's how you do it.
Two down. Runners at first and second. And Hudson outside the zone for a ball. A 1-0 now. And he looks at the slider that's in there. 1-1.
strike.
Good spot that time. Hit that outside corner. 1-2.
I don't think he liked that call very much, but the reality is he couldn't hit that any day of the week. That's a great pitch.
The 1-2 on its way. Here's a fly ball to straightaway left. And there's the third out. So Tim Hudson is out of that inning. And the Athletics coming up next. Fox at the plate. And the fans kind of move to the front of their seats when he comes to the plate. Here's the pitch. That's at the knees for a called strike.
I'll tell you what, people pay money to watch the power hitters, and that's why the Stars make the most money, because they hit the ball out of the ballpark, Gary.
He deals. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1.
Okay, they left four runners on base so far in the game, so they've had a couple of opportunities, you know, to be able to try to make something happen, but just have not been able to come up with a big hit or a long ball.
This is high with that one for ball two.
Well, he tried that four-seam fastball up in the zone to get him the chase. Tough pitch to lay off of. Good job by the hitter.
Come on, Halo. It's 2-1 pitch. Ball. Won't commit on that hard slider. Now 3-1.
Well, even though you're 3-1 in the count, you still have to be patient at the plate. Make him throw a quality pitch. If he does, be ready for it. And if you're the pitcher, you better not throw anything down the middle and hope he's taking it, because he can take you out of the yard.
Strike two. Ooh, he tried to put all of it into that one swing and goes to a full count now, 3-2. Payoff pitch coming. Fastball swung out and missed. Struck him out. One away.
The pitch is too close to take, but you've got to try to make contact with it. Swings right through it. Strike three.
High!
Nobody on base. One away. Swings on that first pitch, misses the fastball, 0-1.
Well, you can tell his timing way off after seeing him swing at that four-seamer.
The pitch takes one off the plate to even the count at one. Two with a swing and a miss on a fastball.
Credit the catcher on that one. That's a good low target setting up, and he hit the target. Good execution.
One-two pitch coming.
You're out.
He got him. So far, 8 strikeouts today.
It's the best pitch in baseball. The fastball down and away. If you can master that, you can be successful. He's successful.
It's going to be Jackson now. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Two outs and nobody on. And the first pitch. Swing and a rocket towards short. And that's out number three.
Now he's bringing it today. Got control of every one of his pitches, keeping the hitters off balance the entire game. They just can't seem to find any answers.
Still unable to score. Oakland still zero.
Well, coming into this game, he's got to have some confidence because he picked up two hits last time out, so got to be seeing the ball pretty well.
First delivery to Molina.
Ball!
That one in the dirt. Good play by the catcher. Kept it in front of him. He sends this one in the air towards center. One away now. Here's a look at what's coming up for the A's. Wednesday, they finish up this Los Angeles series. And after that, they'll be home against the Rangers. They'll have to deal with Josh Hamilton in that power-hitting lineup. Boy, there's some great competition in that set of games. That's going to get going on Friday night. And after that, they face another competitive team at home, the Cleveland Indians. So, a lot of home games to look forward to. And we've got Eckstein batting. A loss for the Angels in yesterday's game. And a tough four-game series. They lost three, just picking up the one win against the Red Sox.
The problem is these guys have been struggling mightily with games away from home.
Bases empty, one out. He takes that one. Hudson has him 0-1. You just got to get that first W on the road. Otherwise, mentally, it starts like, are we ever going to do this?
Yeah, that's the problem. Sometimes that lack of confidence can set in. Every time you get on a plane to travel to another city, you feel like you're going to lose.
Cochran, safe at first. He's in there, not quite getting him.
The good hitters, before they step in the batter's box, check the corner infielders to check what their depth is. He looked around and realized, I've got a chance for a bunt base hit. Well done.
Runner at first with one down. Here's the first pitch. First pitch way out of the zone, ball one.
That two-seam fastball is such an effective pitch. One, because it gets ground ball outs, but two, it sets up his other pitches.
Strike one. That was a called strike of the knees, 1-1. He deals. Sinker just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Well, you want to keep an eye on the runner right here. 2-1 count. They're not likely to pitch out. If the runner gets put in motion, you might see a hit and run right here.
The 2-1 pitch. Fastball on the black. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, even though you're 3-1 in the count, you still have to be patient at the plate. Make him throw a quality pitch. If he does, be ready for it. And if you're the pitcher, you better not throw anything down the middle and hope he's taking it, because he can take you out of the yard.
The 3-2 pitch. And that one is going to be outside, and that is ball four, and now you've got a base stealer on.
Well, the hardest thing to do when you have an at-bat that lasts this long is sometimes you have a tendency to be impatient and chase one. Give the hitter a lot of credit. It was a close pitch, but he laid off of it to earn that walk.
Runners on first and second with one out. And the first pitch. And that's too low, 1-0. At the belt, the 1-0. That one's in the dirt. Nice stop. That swung on and a liner here. Decides not to try for the double play. Hangs on to it.
Well, let's take a look at the Angels and where they ended up last year rank-wise in the American League. Seventh in home runs, seventh in stolen bases, and they were in the top 10 in runs. An offense that was relentless, that ability to continue to put the pressure on the opposition and take pressure off their own pitching staff.
Two down. Runners at first and second. Now the first pitch. Slider misses badly with it. 1-0.
Well, he went for the backdoor slider right there, but he laid off the pitch. Good eye.
On the way. 1-0 delivery is a fastball in there. 1-1. He watches one at the knees, and it's 1-2.
When you throw that breaking ball, you want to throw it down in the zone to get the hitter to chase or just get the bottom of the zone for a strike. That's what he did.
No swing. Count goes to 2-2.
We have to remember these middle relievers. They're not used to coming in and throwing over 45 pitches, but that's where he's at right now. You might see his control run away from him a little bit right here.
Missed inside with a fastball. The count runs full.
You try to run that two-seam fastball down and in. It means you want to get the ground ball. He didn't get it, though, as the hitter lays off the tough pitch.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. And that misses. Ball four. He has loaded him up.
Well, you know, the pitcher's really tired right now, and you have to think that his confidence is a little bit shaken. That long at bat right there, he had a chance to put the hitter away, and now he has to go from the stretch to try to keep this inning from getting out of hand.
Two outs, bases loaded. Here's Anderson's first look. And he watches the low pitch from Hudson.
Now, Gary, we just saw the second walk in this inning, and you really have to start to question, is he nibbling, trying to avoid contact, or is he losing control?
This is below the knees, ball two. And Steve, absolutely right about those walks here. He's got himself in a jam. He doesn't get out of it. His part of the game may be over.
Well, he's finding himself in hitters' counts, and when hitters can look for a certain pitch, they can drive it, so he's in trouble.
Had a rip. Comes up empty. 2-1.
Looking for the ground ball out. Trying to get the hitter to roll over on it. Throws that sinker on the outside corner.
Two-one pitch. And now Anderson has worked it in his favor. 3-1. Matchup, 282 lifetime against Tim Hudson. Ball's in there. 3-2 now.
Well, it's going to turn into a track meet now. 3-2 count. Two outs. Runners are going to be moving.
The 3-2 pitch. That is a called third strike to Garrett Anderson. So Tim Hudson is out of that inning. And the Athletics coming up next. For those of you just coming on board, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Krupp, bringing you Major League Baseball on 2K Sports. First pitch to him. Swung on, hit in the air to right center. One away.
Now, no runs so far, and he's been able to make every pitch he needs to neutralize some of these big bats. Getting the job done, he looks like he's feeling good.
Cochran has a turn in the watch. Oakland coming in, a loss in their last game. Well, they ended up splitting the four-game series, 2-2 against the Mariners in Seattle.
Well, they're playing very consistent baseball right now. And sometimes as a manager, that's all you can expect out of your club.
One out, nobody on. First pitch, here it comes. Fastball, too low, 1-0. Certainly the players would like to do a little bit better than the .500 they're in right now.
Well, absolutely. You know a .500 team's not going to win a division, but they have to improve on that. They have to turn it around right now.
Now the 1-0 pitch. Swung on, liner to right. That is in. It's going to bring the tying run to the plate. Now a look at the standings in the Western Division as we get through the first month of the season. It's brought to you by State Farm. The Mariners, first place. The A's, second place. In third, the Rangers. And it's the Angels in fourth. Bando settles in. Grounded out his last time up. One out, runner on at first. And the first pitch, he got fooled on that one. Takes a cut at a ball down in the dirt. Here's a slider that misses, 1-1.
Look, yeah, listen, he's made pitches. They've had a few base runners on against him, no question about it. They've gotten a few hits, but he's been able to keep them from putting hit after hit after hit together. He's kept him off the scoreboard and let his defense do the work.
On the ground to second. He plays it on the hop. Eckstein's got one. And two. They got both of them that time.
Now, Gary, he's in absolute control out there right now. And I have to suspect they're going to leave him in as long as he can go, as long as the pitch count doesn't get too high.
The Athletics can't get the offense going. We'll have the 6, 7, and 8 hitters coming up next. Salmon in the batter's box. He's going to get things going here. Home half, 7th inning. Swings and misses. The sinker, 0-1. Hudson with a windup. Sinker, 1-1. That misses down in the zone, 2-1. Hit hard on the ground to short. And his throw gets him, one away. Be sure to tune in this Thursday. It'll be Albert Pujols and the St. Louis Cardinals as they find themselves at Minute Maid Park playing the Astros. Start time is 8 Eastern.
Okay, that's going to be a great matchup, and everybody's going to want to tune into that one. I'm looking forward to it.
And Edmund settles in. Over the season last year, 2-for-5 off Tim Hudson. One out, base is empty. Here's the first pitch. Slider swung on and missed, 0-1. Set a curve in there. He's behind now, 0-2.
Well, that's a textbook 12-6 power curve ball right there. You start it up in the zone, break it to the bottom of the zone. Even if they swing and put it in play, you get an out.
Hudson with a windup.
Ball!
Oh, tough one to lay off right there, that fastball, 1-2. Sinker swung on, miss. That's out number 2.
Well, credit the pitcher right there. Good 2-strike pitch down and away. Not much he could have done with that, even if he had made contact. Well, still the early part of the season, but let's take a look at where the Angels sit right now in the American League. 2nd in triples, 7th in batting average with runners in scoring position, and they're in the top 10 in team batting average. That depth and length of the lineup paying big dividends for this team as they seem to find ways to get base hits.
Base is empty with 2 outs. And here's the first one.
Ball.
Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0.
Well, hitters know those two-seam fastballs down and away turn into ground ball out, so they lay off of it. But with 2 strikes, it's a pitch you have to swing at.
Liner towards the hole, and he's there to retire the side. And they go quietly offensively in this half inning. Nothing across. The Angels 2, Oakland nothing. And if you are just coming on board, Gary Thorne, Steve Phillips, John Kruk, as we bring you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Oh, and he checks his swing. He'll call that one a strike. The appeal goes to first. He did, and so with that, he'll step in and try his luck again. Here's the delivery. And Miguel Tejada takes a look at that one. A ball evens the count.
Well, what an outstanding effort by the pitcher today. I mean, he has just been on top of his game, making the pitches, and offensively, they just have not been able to back hits up with other hits to mount the rally. They've been held scoreless here today.
Here's the delivery. Good-looking fastball. Called the ball, though, 2-1. Pitch in the dirt, blocked by the catcher. Into the motion now, the 3-1. Swing and a high drive. This one crunched way back there. And gone, a home run, and the shutout is finally broken.
Just a shame to see the shutout broken up right there, Gary, but still, just a tremendous performance today. Now, Gary, he didn't get all of that one, but he got just enough so that it could clear the wall in right center field.
And that's why that's called the power, Alec.
Well, each at bat has drawn these A's a little bit closer. They're on the verge of overtaking the lead.
No outs and the base is empty. And here's the first one. Ball. Just missed with the fastball, 1-0. And Steve, if we end up at a tie ball game, you're going to look back at that home run and say, this is the one that got them over the top.
Well, the thing that's going to get either of these teams over the top is going to be whose pitcher gets the job done the rest of the way.
Ball. 1-0 is a fastball that runs away, 2-0. Swung on, hit, picked up by Eckstein. And his throw is in time for out number one.
Let's take a chance here right now to see where the Athletics sit in the American League. Second in home runs, fourth in slugging percentage, and they're in the top 10 in team batting average. That depth and length of the lineup paying big dividends for this team as they seem to find ways to get base hits.
One out, nobody on. And the first pitch. Taps this one foul to the right. Swing and a line drive. And it's in there, the tying run on board.
I tried to go down with that 0-1 pitch, but it gets blasted right back for the base hit.
But the way he went after that in the box, Steve, it looked like he might have been guessing down there.
Well, I'll tell you what, you have to make contact behind in the count. He got a pitch over the heart of the plate and he took advantage of it.
Fox at the plate now. Trying again here, just 1-for-3 thus far. One down, runner at first. First pitch, here it comes.
0-1.
And a swinging strike on the first pitch by Rodriguez. 0-1.
Gotta love that location down and away. And with that kind of movement, not many guys are gonna put it in play.
Come on, Damo. Let's go.
He delivers. Swing, shoots this one towards the gap, right center. That one in the alley. This could be two or more. He's around third, and he's heading home. And it's tied up. The tying run crosses the plate. Let's see what the RBI means for their win expectancy.
Well, a great piece of work right there to get that double and put himself in scoring position. He got a fastball and took a good rip at it. Nice, short, compact swing.
It's Baker at the plate. Took a called third strike in his last time up. One out with a runner at second. There he goes towards third. And he is out at third. What a throw. Here's the 1-0 from Rodriguez. Good action to that cutter. Called strike, 2-1.
Well, that cut fastball away, it looks like it's coming down the heart of the plate, runs to the outside corner. It tends to turn into a pop-up.
Now here's a grounder towards the hole. And he'll step on first to retire the side. They come up with two runs to pull even. We are tied up here in L.A. Leading it off, Benji Molina. Tried again here, just 1-for-3 thus far. First delivery to Molina. Watches a curve in there for strike one. Now Hudson with the 0-1 pitch. For some reason, he tried to hit that pitch in the dirt. It's a strike. Here's the pitch. Slider misses, and it's 1-2 now.
Well, this guy's really eating up some innings for this team. He's over the 60-pitch mark right now. And I tell you what, that's a lot of pitches for a middle relief pitcher.
1-2 pitch coming. That swung on, line towards the gap in left center. This one into the gap, rolling towards the wall.
Now this pitch just cuts right over the heart of the plate. The hitter handled it perfectly.
That's one of those where you've given in by making a bad pitch and really made it much easier for the hitter.
Yeah, he's better than that. Fair down.
And we've got Eckstein batting. 2-for-3 thus far. Second base occupied. Nobody out yet. Hudson with a windup. He bunts the ball. Hudson, safe at first. He just made it.
Well, he's trying to advance the runners with this bunt. He's not bunting for a base hit, but once he got it down, he realized this is going to be a tough play, so he hustled down the line. They couldn't get anybody out.
And the number 8 spot rolls around. Walked in his last plate appearance. No one out yet. Runners at first and second. Didn't look like he was going to go anywhere that time, so he's easily back. And the first pitch. That one swung on its line. Gets one. Ooh, I don't think that was the intended play. They blew that one. Oh, he has thrown it away. Safe all around. Bad throw.
Well, it's a big first out right there, but he finds himself still in a jam, in a tie game. Going to be absolutely critical to be aggressive with the next hitter.
Runners at first and third, one away. Here's the first pitch. Swings and misses the slider, 0-1.
Well, this one here, with no doubt about it, the late break on that slider. I mean, what a devastating pitch, and the hitter just couldn't catch up.
Here's the pitch. There's a swing and a smash. Two retired here. Molina's trying for the plate. That's going to break the tie. They lead by one. One run on that one, so we get to see what that does on our win expectancy chart.
I'll tell you what, this is what you want to do. Get runners on in front of this guy, and he knows how to capitalize. Sometimes he knows he needs the big base hit. This time he knew. Put it in play, pick up the run.
Vaughn into the batter's box. Theo, I think from a manager's perspective, he's got to be all smiles over there for this offense producing at this point of the game.
Well, they were given an opening, and they took it. And now they have a lead late in the game.
The first pitch, hit hard to second. Collins, and he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. So they score once on two hits, one man left. L.A.'s got the lead now.
Well, this is what the game of baseball is all about, Gary.
This is a big moment in this game as we're in the top half of the inning here, and he represents the tying run.
Now, Gary, if I had to pick one player to hit in this situation, this is the guy.
Fastball is downstairs. One ball, no strikes.
Now coming down to the wire right here, it's do or die time. You need base runners. Get somebody on. If you get the leadoff man on, it allows you to move him up with a bunt. To sacrifice bunt, you can get him on, get him over, and get him in. This is a critical situation.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind 2-0.
Boy, it's a great fastball right there down in the strike zone. Now there's so many ways to go. Let's see how he comes back to attack this hitter.
That swung on and a liner here. And that gets the tying run on board. And Jackson's trying to stretch it.
Let's take a look at last year's rankings and see how the Oakland Athletics fared. Third in stolen bases, sixth in triples, and they were in the top 10 in doubles, driving the ball out to the wall, playing a lot of wall ball last year, showing that speed coming out of the batter's box and taking the extra bases.
Base runner at second with nobody out. Percival sets and throws, and he tries to get one down, and Molina picks it up. Safe at first, very late throw.
Well, this was a sacrifice situation, but the defense just didn't react properly once the ball was on the ground, and everybody's safe. Well, down by a run here, Gary. The man on first base can run. I'm looking to try to get him to second. Then you got a chance to have the go-ahead run in scoring position. They better keep him close.
Strike started off the at-bat, 0-1. Percival kicks and delivers. Breaking ball, drops low, 1-1. Good pitch on the outside corner, 1-2. The 1-2 on its way. And he takes the ball inside, 2-2.
Well, anytime you're throwing a fastball down in the zone, especially down and in, the only thing a hitter can do is hit that ball into the ground. Good job of laying off.
Lined foul towards third. Here's the pitch. Tough pitch to lay off that time. Full count, 3-2.
Well, he tried that four-seam fastball up in the zone to get him the chase. Tough pitch to lay off of. Good job by the hitter.
And here's the 3-2. Strike three called on the fastball. What a way.
Well, they needed that one. That's the first out. They need to try to limit the damage in this inning and hold on to that lead.
Bando in the box. And he's working the lumber now. Big at bat.
But I tell you what, they need to stay away from the double play ball. It'd be an absolute rally killer here.
Only one away, Steve. Two men on, one out. First pitch to him. Now swinging a shot toward second. This one beyond him. It's going to be extra bases. And they bring across the tying run. That's going to break the tie. They lead by one. Those two RBIs, boy, that makes a difference. We can see just how much on this WPA chart.
We talked about a late inning ball club. They needed a big hit late in the game, in the final inning, and they got it. Clutch hitting, clutch performance. What a team.
Miguel Tejada at the plate. And at this point in the ball game, you'd love to add some more runs on that board.
Now, just get an insurance run or two to protect your relief pitchers when they come into the game.
This could be the put away run or runs. One on, one out. First pitch to Tejada. There is a swing and a liner. And another hit. They're really gunning right now. And he's in there.
You always want a cushion as you send your pitcher out to try to shut down the game. That hit delivers a run, and now it's a two-run game. I think they have the margin they need to hold on to victory.
Henderson tries to do some damage now. So the direction here, Steve, for this lineup, just stay in charge. Right now they are.
Well, my friend Gary, that's a perfect example of clutch hitting we saw right there. He got the job done in a critical situation. They go up by two in the ninth, again, protecting their pitching when they go to the bottom of the ninth.
One out, runner on at first. Oh, Tejada's running.
Strike one!
And he's in there at second base. No balls, one strike. Here, Shields to the left side. Throws to first. He's retired. That's two down. And upcoming for the Angels, final game with Oakland is Wednesday. They take a road trip to face a team they beat in the previous series between the two. The Rays at Tropicana Field. That's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And there's another stop on the road trip. The Boston Red Sox will be hosting. So he'll be on the road quite a bit over this next stretch.
Big-time players live for these moments like this, Gary.
Single and scored his last time around. Runner on second and two outs. Here's the first pitch. Sinker just missed, 1-0.
Wow, he had some good bite on that one right there. But the hitter wouldn't chase it.
That's high, 2-0. Here's the pitch. And here's a sinker for a called strike, 2-1.
A good sinking movement on that pitch, right on the black, away from the hitter. Tough pitch to hit.
Come set. A smash towards the hole. That one threads the needle. That's a base hit.
Good bat speed against that fastball, able to get that inside pitch, rotate his hips, and pull it through the hole for a base hit.
Leadoff man in the box. Two men on, two men out. Oh, he takes off for second. And he is safe, just beating that throw. Ready with a 1-0. 1-0 pitch, a sinker, swung out and missed, 1-1.
This is how you get the routine ground ball, as you pound that sinker down and away, trying to get the hitter to roll over his hands and pound it into the ground.
The pitch. Outside for a ball, and it's 2-1.
Trying to get the ground ball out, you throw that two-seam fastball away from the hitter, trying to get him to reach and roll over it. He laid off of it here.
Now the 2-1 pitch, hit up the middle. Kennedy gets to it. He'll throw one to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. A strike for five base hits in this inning and three runs up. Oakland taking the lead, putting the pressure on. And if you're just joining in, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Kruk bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Eckersley will come in and pitch. He's been chosen to take over out there. And the bottom of the ninth starts with a strike.
Nobody out here in the ninth. You know what they're trying to do. They need to get somebody on and bring the tying run to the plate. That's absolutely critical because that will put pressure on the pitcher.
And Garrett Anderson looks at that one for a ball to even it up. Career numbers, .318 batting average against the A's. Good tailing action to the slurve, 1-2. And Garrett Anderson looks at that one for a ball to even it up. The pitch,
3-2.
Outside for a ball, and it's full, 3-2.
A great movement on that two-seam fastball, trying to start it on the corner, running it off the plate, the hitter just laid off.
3-2 on the way, hit in the air to center field. They take care of that one.
Defensively, you got one out here in the ninth inning. I mean, you want to make a play. Just get an out. You will trade a run for an out here with a two-run lead.
Salmon settling in. He bounced out his last time. Base is empty with one away. First pitch on the way. First pitch, a fastball. That's in there for a strike.
Well, he's got a good four-seam fastball with good riding action to it, but he finds the heart of the plate here. Unfortunately for the hitter, he didn't swing.
Second pitch, cuts on a fastball, misses, and it's 0-2. And there's the slurve, swung on and missed, two down.
This pitch has a little life to it at 84 on the gun and some pretty good movement. Well, two strikes, you have to try to fight off this pitch. You have to think away and adjust in. They went away, but he couldn't make contact.
And Edmonds settles in. He's hit .283 lifetime off Oakland. Base is empty and two down. And the first pitch.
Strike one!
Slider locked him up. He's behind 0-2.
Fans are on their feet right now. They know two strikes on the hitter. They need to keep this thing going.
He deals.
You're out.
Swung on and missed, and this game's history.
McGarry, Oakland wins this game. A lot of contributions all around. The manager's got to be feeling really good about this victory today.
And it's about time to award our player of the game, don't you think? Definitely a key factor in this ball game, Miguel Tejada.
Well, you get on one of these hot streaks, Gary, and all you can do is sit back and watch. And it's an incredible show when it's happening. Spraying the ball all over the field. One just happened to leave the ballpark. That's why he's the player of the game.
And Steve, they're able to put this one away in the record books. It's a good victory.
Hey, anytime you can go on the road and beat another Major League team, you've got to consider yourself fortunate.
And until next time, this is Gary Thorne, along with John Kruk and Steve Phillips. We'll catch you at the yard.